some luck. And I'm going to give them a chance. And we, the historically disenfranchised, demand that he give us one too.
Let's discuss. Jamilah Lemieux, Vice President, News and Men's Programming at Interactive One and former senior editor at Ebony Magazine. She's back with us. Michael Skolnik, CEO of Soze, is here. Joseph Borelli, New York City Councilman and Republican commentator. Mr. Borelli is a Trump supporter. So great having you all on. What a moment, what a monologue. I just kind of want to go round robin and get everyone's reaction. Jamilah, beginning with you.
You know, I thought it was a really great monologue. I enjoyed Chappelle's performance on the show, but I have to say that last moment where he says, I am going to give Donald Trump a chance, did not sit well with me. I was disappointed to hear it. I think it is the sort of, I don't know if cowardice is the word, but that willing to be tolerant and accepting that defines the left is both a gift and a curse. This is someone who ran a campaign on hatred and bigotry, who has, since he has been elected, chosen some of the most dangerous people possible to staff his White House with. And so the idea that we should be tolerant to him, as if our political differences make him a, you know, somebody who's been disenfranchised or discriminated against, as if we can compare Donald Trump to Muslims, to women who are afraid to walk around wearing their hijabs, to trans people who are afraid of going to the bathroom, to people who are afraid to go to their churches because they show up and see anti-Latino sentiments scrawled on a sacred religious space. To say that we all just need to listen to each other, to give each other a chance, to just try and get along.
You wish he hadn't done that.
I wish he had not done that.
Joe Borelli?
Well, I of course have a different opinion than Jamilah. I think Dave Chappelle was number one funny. I think he's a great comedian. But someone as a comedian like him, he has always had this ability to walk that fine line between sort of the offensive and the appropriate between in dealing with certain racial stereotypes of our country. He has lampooned black people and white people and sort of allowed us to view ourselves in a mirror through comedy. I think he's right. People should give Donald Trump a chance. He's also right in that Donald Trump should give the African-American community an open ear. So I don't agree with what you say. I think the Trump campaign has been one that's tried to include a lot of African-Americans, a lot of people of different colors, different creeds, different ethnicities, and I think we're going to see that as President Trump takes office.
Let me come back to both of you, but I want to give Michael some love in Washington. Michael Skolnik, what did you make of all of it, especially as Jamilah pointed out the point when he said, well, give him a chance, but he needs to give us a chance too.
Well, I disagree with that, but let's just say, for argument's sake, let's give him a chance. In 24 hours, less than 24 hours after Dave Chappelle made that comment, this president-elect appoints a white supremacist, anti-Semite, to work down the hallway from him and advise him at the most senior level. There's your chance, America. You gave him 12 hours, and he appoints an anti-Semite, anti-woman, racist, white supremacist as his senior advisor. How much
You're
more of a chance should we give him now?
How event, let me just turn back. So you sort of agree with Michael, Jamilah. He's a president-elect. I understand, you know, there have been cries from even within Republican establishment over the choice of Steve Bannon. What then? How do we move forward if we, without the man even being inaugurated, is already being eviscerated?
I mean, I don't think we have any choice but to eviscerate him at this point, you know, and that's unfortunate. It's a difficult position to be in as a member of the media, as a voting person. I think that organizations like the Southern Poverty Law Center and the ACLU and the NAACP, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, media organizations like my own, people doing work like what Michael is doing now, we have to hold this administration accountable now and when he's officially installed. I think we have to be honest about some of the things that are troubling about him beyond just his hateful language. This is someone that we now know wasn't quite prepared for the scope of the work. And so now President Obama is expected to spend more time helping him and his team transition into White House life. And this is the same person who was forced to present his papers. He had to present his birth certificate as a sitting president, because this person decided to create his political career from this unhinged, bizarre birther movement, as if this country would elect a black man that could have been disqualified at the gate for not being born in America. This guy now needs President Obama's help. because he can't do the job quite yet. He didn't know how hard it was going to be. He doesn't want to live in the White House every day. He wants to go to Mar-a-Lago. He wants to be in Trump Tower. We have to be honest about those things. Do I want him to do terrible things as he has promised that he will do? No. Is it possible that he can exceed our expectations and be a better president to all than maybe we thought? Sure. Should we prepare for that? No. And so I hope that the Dave Chappelle's of the world, the people that have as huge a platform as he do, instead say, we can find the comedy in these moments, we can find the ways to connect people of differing, you know, backgrounds and opinions, but don't fall short of holding him accountable for the things that he said and has done 12 hours later.
How do you respond?
Look, you know, there were three people originally who really had the right tone after Donald Trump won. It was Donald Trump in his victory speech, it was Hillary Clinton in her concession speech the next day, and it was President Obama. And now today I learned we could also add Bernie Sanders, who's saying we should stop these protests and come together and move forward. Donald Trump now, in his first interview, not his second, not his third, not his 20th, in his first interview with anybody, with 60 Minutes, came out and said, I want to be a president for all people. I think you really should give him a chance. I think you should take the advice of, sort of guidance from people like President Obama, who has said he's willing to work with the transition team. And look, I have hope for the new president. I hope you do too. I'm sure you're going to stick to criticizing him when it's appropriate. That's part of the American democracy. But give a chance to the guy who to become the president that we all deserve.
Go ahead, Michael. Go ahead.
I would just say, I think President-elect Trump has to do a very important thing. He lost a popular vote. 52% of Americans who voted against his agenda. He needs to look at the American people and say, I will create a unity cabinet. I will create a cabinet of Democrats and Republicans. I will listen to the people who have spoken. I do not have a mandate. This country is divided. And I will create a cabinet that is anti-hate and anti-corruption. We've already seen the folks who are advising him are all lobbyists. He said last night in 60 Minutes, I don't know who else to hire because they're the only ones who know D.C. So the President-elect Trump has to look at the American people. If he wants our trust, and he wants us to give him a chance. He has to tell us he will not appoint people who continue to be hateful and not appoint people who continue to corrupt Washington as he said he would get rid of them.
Michael and Jamilah and Joe, thank you so much. I appreciate it. We should be having these conversations on live national television. Coming up next, we'll talk live.